What's going on, everyone? It's Josh as Unigamer here. I have just jumped off the stream of the live Microsoft conference at E3, and I am here to give you a rundown, a guide of what we have just witnessed, and if you didn't get to see it, what you have missed live. It was good. I'm recording this straight after, so I haven't seen any other people's opinions. So everyone else right now might be like absolutely flaming it, but it was good. There's a few good games in there, and it just comes down to the Sony conference for me. You know, I'll get whichever, you know, appeals to me more, and it's just largely about the games. But anyway, let's get on to what happened in the show. There were a couple of things announced before the show. Kinect Sports 3, anyone? No one cares. But yeah, and then they talked about the Summer of Arcade a bit, but none of those games really interest me. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles and some other stuff, whatever. But then the good stuff started, or at least most of it was good stuff. First off, it opened up with a Metal Freaking Gear trailer, which, of course, is coming out on the PS3 as well. That's confirmed, right? I'm pretty sure it's coming out on PS3 as well. So it wasn't the best thing to open with, maybe, because it wasn't like, boom, we've got this, no one else has. But regardless, it looked so good. I mean, the graphics were just amazing. I can't wait. You can ride a horse sideways. I mean, who doesn't want to do that in a video game? It looked like the game was, well, it didn't look like it said the game was basically a open world. Well, not open world, but like open sort of scenarios. So it ain't no corridor stealth game. Not that Metal Gear Solid has ever been that exactly, but it's just much more open. Watch the trailer, you'll see it looks really good. Which just sounds cool to me. It's really good. Like, check the trailer out. I'll try and see what else there is on that for sure. So I can't wait for that. They also, which I thought was nice, they talked about stuff to do with the 360 still. I like the fact that, you know, they didn't forget about the 360. It will still be around. Many people will still be playing the 360 for a long time before they can get the Xbox One. So it's good they mentioned that. They're doing a new thing, it seems, with Gold for Gold members from July, and it's similar to PlayStation Plus, I guess. Well, yeah, it's very similar to PlayStation Plus. Basically, if you're on Gold from July, you get 2 free game downloads per month. I don't know whether they're doing that forever or what, which sounds really cool. They did then announce which games it were, and they're basically 2 games that probably everyone's played. Assassin's Creed 2, which not only everyone's played, but it's also very old now, and then also Halo 3, which is very much the same thing. So that could be cool, I guess, in the future if they do some better games. They then went on to show what had been, there had been rumours speculating, but if any of you know the PC, I'm not sure if it's classed as like an MMO, but it's an online PC game, World of Tanks. That is now coming to 360. I've never been that intrigued to play it, because I've never been much of a, you know, even on Battlefield, I won't get in a tank very often. But, you know, it's very popular on the PC, and it's coming to 360, and it's free to play. And they had a cool sounding guy talk about it, so that could be quite cool. I'll definitely give it a go when it comes out on 360. Next, they shoo a trailer for Dark Souls 2. Obviously, this is coming out on PS4, I imagine, as well. It was just a trailer, nothing new, but still, I can't wait for that. That's not till March 2014, I think. And then, finally, well, not finally, it didn't take long, they moved on to the Xbox One stuff, the stuff we had all been waiting for and eagerly anticipating. First, they shoo us the Roman player-controlled game called Rise. I instantly was very intrigued, because I didn't really know, like, people did know about this before apparently, but I didn't really know much about it. You get to play as a Roman, which is cool, because Romans are cool. Graphics once again looked great on the demo they shoo. Only thing that I'm not sure it was good and bad is they shoo like these, like, you'd be fighting, you'd be slashing some guys, and then like you'd get them groggy, and this quick time, this little mini quick time event starts where you just have to hit X and then Y or something, and you'll like chop his arm off and finish him. It was like finishes, and it had happened to pretty much everyone he was fighting, and like it didn't like cut away into a scene every time you'd done it, but it just kind of looked a bit annoying having to constantly do these little mini quick time events. But they did look good, you know, looked fancy, you know, and they'd cut an arm off, cut a limb off, and it looked nice. So I don't know, I'm sure it will probably work, and I think they definitely said they're showing gameplay demos, you'll be able to play it at E3, so I'm sure that will get covered up and that will be fine. Then what happened next is the big Rare announcement that had been hinted at. I personally, a lot of people hate me for this, I wanted Banjo, and I know a lot of other people did. Like, I wanted a good old fashioned Banjo game. However, it was largely rumoured it was going to be the fighting game Killer Instinct. Now, this is a game that, please don't hurt me, I've never played the original, never really knew anything about it until I started hearing the rumours it was going to be at E3. But I appreciate the fact that a lot of people did want it, I know that, so I think it was a good move by Microsoft and Rare. Hopefully it will be good. There was a little bit of gameplay later on in the show, which seemed like a fighting game, but as I said, I really don't know much about it, and they didn't really talk that much about it either, but that would be cool for those guys. Another game that they went on to, which wasn't really talked about too much, was a new IP called Sunset Overdrive. It was made by Insomniac, and they explained it as a stylized shooter. The trailer they played, it looked pretty cool. Like, it wasn't gameplay, it was CGI, and it looked colourful. It looked very nice and colourful. It was cartoony. It is an exclusive to the Xbox One, but there was no gameplay shown at the conference, so I don't know exactly what that would be like, but the trailer was cool. Then they went on to something that I will play, it will be cool, Forza 5. We all knew about it, obviously, from the reveal. There was some racing shown. It was, you know, it's a racing game, you know what to expect. It looks sexy as shit. Shit's not very sexy, but you know what I mean. They announced this thing for it called a Drivatar, and basically what it is, I think, from what I grasped, is it learns how you race from what just logging what you're doing, and it logs these stats about you in the cloud. So instead of playing against your standard AI, you then play against other people's drivatars, which have been created from the Xbox watching how you play. So when you then play a random race, you're essentially playing against like your friends' drivatars, so they're friends, sort of thing, like your friends. So it's kind of cool. If it works, it's going to be awesome, and it will change, you know, change racing games. And I really hope it does work, because it will be much more fun. Because just doing single player will almost be like playing against your friends without even having to have them online. So that's cool. Another thing which I didn't know was going to happen, I don't know if anyone did, it's not that exciting, but Minecraft is coming to the X1. It's cool, you know. I don't know if it will be any different to your standard Minecraft on 360. Or even different to the PC version, I don't know. I don't know what's happening really with the future of Minecraft, but that's good for you Minecrafters. They then talked about Quantum Break a bit more. This was obviously also announced at the reveal, and they just basically explained you play as a guy, survived an experiment which broke down time or something, so time can be paused or whatever. And they shoot this little CGI trailer, and it's just like time is paused and the faces looked amazing, and it was all in engine, or so they say. So they say, and it had some funny looking screaming lady, which was funky. But didn't see any actual gameplay of that, although I think they have got it at E3, so we will see some of that, which is awesome. Then there was this random game, I didn't take any notes because it just looked boring as shit, called D4. D4 equals snore, I put, but it might be cool. They didn't show much. And then another kind of surprise, the next surprise, was Project Spark. Basically what this is it allows anyone, the user, to make a game using Kinect, so using your voice. and smart glass. So using your tablet, your Windows 8 tablet or whatever tablet supports smart glass. And it just allows you to create like a game world. You then can give certain things personalities, you make enemies, you make a village or something. They didn't go too in depth with it, but it seemed like a sort of like Little Big Planet. You can make any sort of game from this sort of play area that you're just given, which should be pretty sweet. Okay, is it still recording? I don't know. So yeah, Project Spark, go watch the little trailer they will shoot. It looks, you know, it looks like it could be cool, and if it's as good as they say, you're going to be able to make some cool little games out of it, hopefully. Next, they went to talk about, basically, well, they ended up talking about more the smart glass integration and how this time it's built into the Xbox One. You can control the Xbox with it, so all control from a tablet. You can compare stats with friends and set up games, that sort of thing on it. So it's, I guess it's going to probably work the Xbox the same way like the Wii U controller does. So that's another reason why the Wii U is pointless. But don't blame me. I would like a Wii U. I just don't have one. There's a few games I'd like to play on it, I'm not going to lie. But anyway, where was I? Another thing which is going to affect, I guess, us YouTubers in some way is it's got an in-game and in Xbox DVR kit. And then it's called Upload Studio. This is where they show a bit of Killer Instinct gameplay. They shoot him playing and winning, and then basically he could cut bits. He recorded it on his Xbox, stick them together, do some editing, and made this quick little montage, and then uploaded it to the cloud for everyone to see. It looked cool. It's hard to tell, obviously. We didn't really get a full walkthrough of how it works and what you can do, but they said there was a whole suite of editing features, so that could be cool. It could be handy, especially for people who, you know, want to do sort of YouTube videos but don't have the equipment. So that could be good. It could be pointless. It's very much similar to what Sony shoe with the PS4. So there's already a similarity between two consoles. Start talking about Xbox Live. It's got built-in Twitch live streaming, which is cool, especially for me. I've never live streamed yet. I've got an Elgato, which I obviously use for my videos. I've just never got around to trying to stream yet. Maybe one day. No more Microsoft points. This was a rumored flying around the internet. That is true. There are no more Microsoft points. It's just currency, real life currency. So that'll make buying things a lot easier. Another cool thing potentially was Xbox Live Gold sharing. Basically, if one of you in the house has got gold, you can share your content. Everyone in that house on that console can use your gold. Gold stuff. So I don't know if you download a game or whatever that only gold people can play, and then your sister logs in on another account, she can then play that same game. I think that's what it is. Another game I'm personally not too interested in but could be cool is Crimson Dragon, which was made by the same guys as Panzer Dragoon. So I know that was a very popular game back in the day. It looked quite similar from what I could tell. I don't know much about it, but if you like Panzer Dragoon, then that's probably one to look out for. Next one, which I don't know if it had been rumoured or not, but I wasn't fully expecting it, was Dead Rising 3. It looked a lot cooler. Like, I wasn't a huge Dead Risings. I played them both. Didn't like the over-the-top arcadeness of them. It was fun to just mess around, but you couldn't even do that much because you had a time limit. Then you have to rescue survivors. It's all very annoying. But this one, it looked a lot better. You play as the main character, Nick Ramos. He's the main guy. Seems to have a much more darker and serious tone. There's still tons of zombies everywhere, and you can still take down loads. But it looked more gritty. It seemed to have more of an open world. It's not set in a mall or whatever. It's set outside. I can't remember where they said. And it looked creepier, and there were cars to drive around in to scavenge for stuff. And then it ended with him using smart glass again to call in an artillery strike. I don't know how you get access to artillery, but who cares? Next thing was The Witcher 3. That is going to have free roaming, which is awesome. He said easily over 100 hours of gameplay, which is awesome. And it's got voice commands, which no one cares about. But that should be pretty epic. They show a short trailer for that. It looked badass. I can't wait for that, so that will be good. After that, it was Battlefield 4, which, to be honest, I enjoy the Battlefield games, I enjoy COD games, I enjoy most first-person shooters. Some of them are getting a bit stale. The graphics were all very nice and all that ting, but that was after some heckling from the crowd and an awkward silence from the crowd because it didn't actually work. The trailer didn't play and the guy was just standing on the stage like a lemon, not even knowing what to say. And then eventually it started off and it was all fancy. It was on a boat or something that was getting blown up. You're just trying to kill people and escape. And it looked very pretty, of course. It looked like a Battlefield trailer. I feel as though it wasn't quite so surprisingly graphically awesome because Battlefield 3 looked so good. But it was definitely, it's Battlefield. I don't really know. I'm not. We'll see when it comes to gameplay. And Xbox has got exclusive DLC. Woo. Phil Spencer also changed his top halfway. That's another note I took. He then announced another cool-looking indie game, which is promising. It's called Below. They show a short trailer. Don't really know much about it, but it's a good sign on the indie game front. Hopefully, there's more. We were then told this developer called Black Tusk is working on a AAA exclusive game. They didn't give a name for it. They show a quick cinematic, which didn't really show much. It's kind of pointless, but that's something to look forward to. Hopefully. Then announced that there's definitely going to be a new Halo game on the Xbox One in 2014, and it's going to run at 60 FPS. Whoop whoop. And then coming towards the end of the show, they finally announced the price: $499 in America, £429 in the UK. I can't remember how many euros it was. It was obviously close to 499. So there's your prices. It's about what everyone thought. I have no idea how I'm going to be able to afford one, but fingers crossed I will somehow get one. And then finally, they ended on Titanfall. It's a first-person, free-running shooter, mech suits, multiplayer, jetpacks. Looks so good. Game. They show some gameplay, and I knew nothing about this one before, and I didn't even know it was a multiplayer game until the gameplay started showing. It looks awesome. It looks really cool. There's jetpacks. You can run along walls. You then can call a mech suit down, jump in it, and take on another guy in a mech suit. And then he ejects out of the mech suit, fires in the air, lands on top of the other mech suit, shoots it, takes it out, blows it up, and it just looked awesome. And if anything's going to be a COD killer, then I think it might be that game, but we'll have to wait and see some more videos for that. Although unfortunately, that's a 2014 release, so that won't be coming out with the console. But I think they're pushing that as one of the big selling points for the Xbox One, and it looked pretty awesome. I can't wait to see some more from that. And that was it, basically. Overall, I enjoyed it. What else would I have wanted? It would have been nice if they had tried to kind of cement over the damage they made at the reveal, in that they tried to calm people about the whole privacy issues, which I'm not too worried about. I don't think they're going to be watching us through Kinect or whatever. You can say what you want about it, and all the other problems like the DRM. None of these problems I'm that worried about. Like, they're always online. Like, I haven't not been online with my Xbox in a long time, but obviously I can understand why people are, and it would have been nice if they'd, tried to kind of make people feel a bit better about that actually at the conference. But regardless, to me it's all about the games, and they did deliver quite a few. Obviously, we've still got all the developer conferences to come, and more importantly, we've got the Sony conference to come. And that's going to be a big deciding point on where I go in terms of getting an Xbox or PS4. So there you go, guys. I'll do the same thing for the Sony conference later on. Can't wait to watch that. It's on at like 2 a.m. in England, so I'm going to be knackered. So that might take a little bit longer to put up the my analysis or my guide for it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter. Thank you to my subscribers already. I know it's a very small number, but it makes me very happy. And thank you for getting that State of Decay Part 1 up above 50 views. It means a lot to me. Some of you may think it sounds silly, but we've got to start somewhere, and it's good. So don't forget to subscribe as well if you want to see more of the series I've got. I've got State of Decay, as I said. I've got Dead Island, which is about to finish. I've already done a Metro Last Light, and I've also got, what else have I got? Oh, Remember Me highlights. And not forgetting Last of Us comes out on Friday. I will be covering that. So check out the annotations that I'm putting all over the place. I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Comment in the box on what you liked most about the Microsoft conference or what you didn't like most. And I will see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye!